Okay, I'm going to go over the hookups of the system. First, you have the laptop stand. You go ahead and open that up. This is a tray that you put on there. And then all you have to do is there's chrome knobs that adjust it. Put the mixer right over the stand. This is just to give you a demonstration if you wanted to put an external drive there and sit it on the stand itself. So you have your mixer. Get your microphones ready. And what you do is you have everything color-coded. You have four wireless microphones, all color-coded, green, yellow, orange, and blue. Corresponds right here. Everything's color-coded here. Even the front, as well as the backs. And you could switch this around any way you want. If you wanted to make these number three and four instead, you could do that. Or just switch around the actual microphones. After you plug up your wireless microphones, then you plug in your monitor, and you'll see that it says monitor, and then right here, this says monitor input. Then the other end of this goes into the monitor. And this also has a label that says monitor. This is a 10-inch PVX P10 powered speaker. Then over here you have the main inputs, which is left and right mixer out. And you'll see that it says left and right. So these two go out to the back of the speakers. And then you'll notice I have the speaker set here. So you could have it between 12 and here. And if you're just doing straight DJ, you could go further, but I really wouldn't go past this. And then you'll see the contour and flat. For the main speakers, I have it pushed in, but for the monitor, I have it pushed out to run flat. Then you have your HDMI splitter. So you come out of whatever laptop you're going to use, HDMI, go into the input, and then come out of one of the outputs and go into the TV. You could come out of three more outputs and go to three different TVs. Going around to the back here. This is the USB cable that comes out of the back. Then you also notice right here it says 7878. Remember that for when you use the Bluetooth. That's the password to get in. So you plug in right here, and then you just go USB into your laptop. Now, when powering everything up, you go ahead and power up your wireless microphones. There's a button in the back of the mixer. Turn that on. Wait to see the LEDs. And then the last thing you want to do after everything's powered up is power up your speakers. Now you'll notice the way I have this set up. Our shop is an old bar from the 1940s. It has 12-foot ceilings, and it's actually 30 by 40. So you imagine we have a stage right here, and typically the way we would set this up is I would most often set it on the stage and have one speaker there and then have another speaker on the other side of the room and then the monitor behind the mains. Once everything's powered up, then you go ahead and turn on your computer. And when you're in your computer, the one thing you want to look at is there's the speaker icon here. We'll give it a chance to focus in real quick. And it says speakers USB. That's what you want to see. And if for any reason you don't see it, unplug the USB in the back and plug it back in. The next thing we're going to go over is the actual settings on the wireless mics, the mixer, and we'll go over the back of the speaker again as well. Okay, we're gonna go over the initial settings. Each of these wireless microphones have the knobs here, and it's hard to see. Make sure you look at the light. It'll be set right around 11 o'clock if you think of a clock, and that's all four of them. The backs, like I said, are color-coded. The female end goes into the wireless microphones, and then the male end goes into the mixer. Talked about the back of the speaker real quick again. You see the clip light, always make sure that stays in the green. And I wouldn't go past this. I've even went as high as this just for regular music, but it seems to be between 12 and 2 o'clock is the best way. And then looking at these cables, the male end that says right speaker, that goes in. And I know we already went over this, but I figured I would look at it again. And then the other end is female. And just make sure you do left to left and right to right. Okay, now let's go over the settings. Looking at the mixer, this is your master volume. You have the master volume on the back of the speakers. Then this is the next set of volumes. You'll notice it has this whole area here, and there's a line here. You could go as low as here and as high as here. So if I'm DJing and I don't have to worry about microphones, I would push it up to there. But it seems like it works best right here. But it's going to be different depending on the acoustics. You may want to change it. So just know that that's the first thing you could change. Then the next thing you look at is your gains for each of the channels. You have four gains. Then you have two gains right here, and that's for your music channels, and those are your microphone channels. You'll notice that they're almost set the same. So if you think of a clock, I have this set right around 11 o'clock for microphone 1 through 4, and then this is also right around 11 o'clock, even though it looks a little bit further up. In fact, this is 10 o'clock. And this is 11 o'clock. You could go from 9 o'clock to 10 o'clock for the most part. And one way to make sure that you're not going too far, one way to test it, you turn your volume all the way down. Then you also, this is the monitor. So you turn that all the way down. You have to remember, you have two knobs you're working with that's controlling your main and your monitor. So check 1, 2. Actually, let me grab the other microphone. Check 1, 2. So see how the first thing you see is the green light? You notice that this is red, that means it's on mute. So the first thing you do is you unmute it. Check 1, 2. So now this is going to get a signal. So watch, if I take the gain and put it all the way down, check 1, 2. See how I'm barely getting anything? So what you do is you test it by basically mic checking it very harsh. So you go, check 1, 2. So keep an eye on the signal, and then you'll start to see the clip if I go too high. Check 1, 2, check 1, 2, check 1, 2, check 1, 2. Check 1, 2. So see how I did that real harsh one? Go down. Check 1, 2. So once again, I'm back down around 10, and that seems to work. Now, also, there's a white button here. If I push that in over to the right, you see how you can see the LEDs? So check 1, 2. Check 1, 2. See how it goes into the yellow? So to me, that's basically where I wanted as far as setting the gain for that channel. Same thing with the music. You could do the same thing. Typically, going between 5 and 6 is good. This says 5 and 6, and this says 3 and 5, which, if you think of the numbers, 1, 2, 3 dots, 5 dots, that's another way to look at it. Did not want to make a label that basically said 12 o'clock and this and that. But you get the drift. Here, keep it right around here. I think that would work the best. And then you could also test this when you do the music. Have this in, and then you'll see that, and just make sure you keep it in the green. Okay, so that's your gains. So you have your master volume, then you have your gains. Now look at the next thing. When you understand one row, you've already understood four, because they're all identical to each other for the most part. The next set of knobs that you have here, it's called a compressor. It's on 1 and 2, because typically you don't have four singers, and the bigger mixers are the ones that have more features and so forth. But you look at this, the compressor, I have this set right around 10 o'clock. Then I have the highs set in between, it's almost right around 11 o'clock, just a titch below 11. The mids, I have that right on 11. And the lows, I have right around 10. Now let's go ahead and bring the microphone in. Check 1, 2. I'm gonna bring in the monitor first. Check 1, 2. Check 1, 2. Check 1, 2. Check 1, 2. Bring in the mains. Check 1, 2. So now I have everything going. Depending on the room, you can EQ it different. There's a white bypass button here. If I hit this, check 1, 2, that just basically keeps the EQ. It would be as though I brought this all to 12. So if you like it better this way, you could go ahead and work with it, just watch the feedback. But the way I put this, it's a little bit cleaner. And what you do is you have someone in the middle of the room listening to you talk. And then what you do is you kill the EQ. So now you took out the lows. Now listen to it when I bring the lows back in. I'll bring it up real high. See how it's a lot bassier? And then it's gone. So what you're doing is you're essentially, you keep talking, test 1, 2, test 1, 2. And then you basically want to stop where you feel that it's a sweet spot. And you do the same thing with the mids. If all you're doing is speech, you could typically go further on this. The mids work perfect between 11 o'clock and 2 o'clock. So let's go ahead and bring that down. Check 1, 2. So you hear how it sounds very hollow now. And then go ahead and bring up the mids. So see how the speech is much more pronounced. So if I went right around 2 o'clock, that may sound fine for speech. But on the same token, when you're singing, you may not want that. So a lot of times I'll have that right around 11 o'clock, maybe between 11 and 12. It's just a titch past 11. Go ahead and try it any way you want. You do the same thing with the highs. You bring that down, all the highs are gone. Bring it up, a lot of highs. Typically, I never go past 12 o'clock with highs, but that depends on where your speakers are. The way things are positioned, that could give you more leeway. But we're gonna go ahead and put that back down to 11. Okay. So now you understand the gain. The compressor, just leave that right around there. That's going to compress someone's vocals if they're trying to scream in the microphone. You have your EQ. Then I labeled this for you. That's the monitor. So this is where your stage monitor is being controlled on every single channel. So I'm going to go ahead and turn off the mains. So now all I have is that little speaker that was over to the right. Check 1, 2. It's gone. Bring it back in. I normally wouldn't want to bring it really high, but if you're able to do it without having a lot of feedback, because you're going to start to hear that ringing, and you'll get used to adjusting the board, but for the most part, in between 10 and right around 1 o'clock is probably where I would go. Check 1, 2. Check 1, 2. But for the most part, this is where I have it set. Go ahead and adjust it however you want. Then below this, you have the echo. Now, the echo is associated over to the right here. This is your echo station. It's your echo station. It's your media player for the MP3 when you insert a USB over at the top. So if you look at the top here, there's a USB right here. And you can plug that in. And the reason why you're seeing that blinking is because I have the Bluetooth on. Now going back down here, this serves as the player. That's the knob for the player when you put the USB in. This is for the effects. So right now, it's going to be a little hard to see, but let's go ahead and try to bring this in and try to tilt it and focus it somehow. And you might be able to see the lighting makes it real difficult on camera to get this. So I'm going to have to just tell you what I'm looking at. Right now, because I have it on the effects, it says 6 REV vocal. And if I push this, then it shows the time, which means how much echo am I putting in. Right now it's at 20 and it seems fine. So let me go ahead and, bring up the volume so you can hear it more. And I'm going to push this again, and let's see, if I went down to 0, now it's flat. But if I went up to 99, check, 1, 2, crazy echo. Let's go back. So you're pushing it, then you're turning it. So let's say I'm going to keep you at 20, and then you adjust it however you want. Go into each room and try it. Go into 7. This is vocal big. Check 1, 2. Go into 8. That's reverb vox warm. So it sounds different, and depending on, push it again until you see the time. If you adjust it higher, check 1, 2. So you're going to hear more of the effects. So what you typically want to do is you want to set these first, and when you set it, press it. It brings it back to 1 through 15 or so, and you just scroll right and left to go to the ones. But I would tell you to stay on 6, reverb vocal, press it in, and keep it that way. And then you adjust your echo right here with the light gray knobs. Even this, if I go all the way down, check 1, 2. If all I was doing was speech, not karaoke, I would kill the effects because that's how people want to hear it. So if I want to hear a lot of effects, check 1, 2. So not only are you able to adjust it over here, you're able to adjust it here. The premise of this is basically no different than the volume. So when I talked about this, and then being able to adjust each channel, that's the same thing for the effects over here. Once you set this and you find what you like, then you finally fine tune with the echo over here to where you want it. So I'm gonna bring it back down to about 10 o'clock. Now below this is what's called a pan knob. It's basically a balance knob. If you're playing music, this actually might be cool if you're going from left to right. It basically makes the system sound, I guess it's kind of cool for DJ. But for the most part, you're not even going to use this. You're going to keep it up straight the whole time. Below this is your mute buttons. These are your best friends. You have to get used to, when you're not using other microphones, keep them muted. Same thing with the channels. So let's say all you're doing is you have one singer most of the night, and you have the media channel. So that's unmuted. And you could use that. Now let's say you have all 4 singers and something goes on and you have to completely cut them out. Instead of turning down the volume on each knob, over to the right here is a mic mute. So if I hit this, check 1, 2, check 1, 2. It kills the mains, but you could still hear me. Now why is that? Because the monitor is completely separate. Check 1, 2. So you have to remember when you're dealing with this that you have 2 main volumes for each channel. Then of course you have your volume here that we talked about.
And then you have your button down here that allows you to, when you press it, then now all of a sudden you're able to gauge how much you're putting in the signal and so forth. But this white button is not only used for that. Let's say you're on here using your laptop, and then you want to set up and plug in a player up here, or even an iPad or an iPod with that little eighth inch plug. It's a little hard to see back there. And you want to listen to it. That's when you could do this. And then over here, you could have your headphones in and listen to whatever you have here. So it's used for two different things. Okay. Go ahead and mute these again. Now, when you do your mic check, bring everything down. First thing you're gonna do is your mic check. You see how you have the monitor? You start bringing in your monitor. Check, one, two. Check, one, two. Check, one, two. Check, one, two. So you wanna try different ways and figure out where it works best for you. Now let's look at the monitor real quick. If you look at the monitor, I stuck it up on a stand just so I could have it blaring at my ear, but you could set that monitor on the floor, just angled. It even has flying points on it that you could take off the things, put bolts in them, eye bolts, and actually hang it on the ceiling and then tilt it. You basically could tilt it downward. So try this in a lot of different areas. If you have something you could sit it up on, you could go ahead and do that. And I'm going to show you something real quick. Over here on the stage, when we have it set up with the karaoke and we have a small system, there's a lot of times that we'll have the one speaker. There's another speaker over here. We'll have a speaker right there. And then what we'll do is we'll go ahead and have that smaller speaker basically shooting across the stage. Okay. So now you understand all the microphone aspect. And then over here, you have a high pass filter on each of these. I have them pushed in. Basically, what that does is it helps with the handling noise. And then you go ahead and you have this white button here. Next thing I want to go over real quick is when you're playing your music, you want to make sure that you balance it out with your microphones. So try to mix it and get it balanced. But remember, when you're doing your sound check, you're bringing up the monitor first. And then when you like that, you keep it like that. You bring up the echo, keep it like that. Then you bring up your mains for the microphones. Now over here, you have return to main. This basically controls the echo for the mains, and this allows echo to go into the monitor. So you could turn this completely off if you don't want to hear it in the monitor and you want to hear it flat, or bring it up. I'm going to keep it right at basically 10 o'clock. This is at 11 o'clock. Your master volume that controls the monitor is set right around 11 o'clock. You keep it that way as well. And then the next thing I'm going to talk about real quick is the auto-tune feature. These two microphones have auto-tune, okay? You press that in. In fact, here. If I hit auto-tune right now, even though you can't see it, if I was on the first one, if I turn this on, you can make your vocals really funky. Check one, two. Shimmy-doo-wop-wop-way-bay-bay-bay. So it totally transforms your vocals. But for dummies, you want to set this at 9, which is chromat, and keep it right around 7, and maybe even bring up the speed more. So you click it again, keys chromat speed, and then you bring up the speed until it is really hard for someone to hear it.
So I'll leave it at 20 for you. Then it says detune. Leave that alone because that's like for a piano or something. So when you have it on 9, speed 20. It's a little hard to hear, but it's going to help with the pitch control when someone's singing. Now the other thing up here, you have USB A, B, and then you have Bluetooth. So A is if you're running the USB player. B is what it's supposed to be on for your laptop. And when you bring it over to Bluetooth and you turn on the Bluetooth and you go into your settings, it's going to ask you for that number for the password. Now, one of the things I want you to remember, if you turn this on, disconnect anything, reconnect it, you may not hear the laptop and you think something's wrong with it. So remember to check your icon on your computer and make sure that it shows that it's USB. And if not, right click, go into playback devices, and then go ahead and make sure that this is on. If it's not on, then what you do is you just unplug the USB and plug it back in. Same thing with the HDMI splitter. If anything disconnects on that, go ahead and connect it, unplug it, plug it back in, and it will reboot it. Read the manual, take your time with this. Once you get used to it, it's an exceptional mixer. As long as you keep watching the video over and over again, you're gonna be just fine.